Hello everyone, welcome to another tutorial from Brilliant Bios. In this lecture, I will discuss complement pathway. It is a very important topic. Today's topic is classical complement pathway. There are three types of pathways by which complement protein can be activated. One is called classical complement pathway, another is alternative pathway, and the last is lectin pathway. In this class, I will only discuss about classical complement pathway. In the beginning, I want to mention complement pathway composed of some proteins that are called complement protein. These proteins are present in the serum or plasma of our blood. These proteins are called C1, Q, and C2, C3, C4, C5, and etc. So this C1 means complement protein. So this complement protein are present in the serum of our body. And this complement pathway actually cooperate with the innate and adaptive immunity. I will discuss about this. For the classical complement pathway, one important point is you have to remember there must be an antigen and an antibody complex. So for the classical complement pathway, there must be antigen and antibody complex. The antibody should be IgM or IgG. These two antibody, when form a complex with antigen, this pathway is activated. Here I want to mention, in these two antibody IgM and IgG, the IgM is more preferable for this formation of this complex. Why? Because IgM in the soluble form, it is present in a pentameric conformation. Pentameric means the five antibody of IgM bind with each other and form a soluble IgM antibody, pentameric in nature. So one antibody have two binding sites with the antigen. So the five or pentameric IgM can have 10 binding site of antigen. But whereas the IgG contains only two arm for antigen binding. So IgM is very preferable for this classical complement pathway. You have to remember this. Another important point is, you can ask me if this antibody and this antigen can actually activate the classical pathway. Is the IgM antibody, when is present in the serum, can activate this protein, complement protein? The answer is no. When the IgM antibody is present in the serum, it form in a planar conformation. In this conformation, the initiator protein, there are complement protein that initiate the complement pathway, initiator. In this case, in case of classical complement pathway, the initiator protein is called C1Q protein. This protein is initiator protein. I have written is C1Q protein. And I have mentioned that these all proteins are present in the serum. And you all know that antibody is also present in the serum. So is there any chance that this initiator protein can bind with the IgM in the serum? No, because in the serum, the IgM have a planar conformation in which the IgM have no binding site for the C1Q protein. So C1Q protein cannot bind in the serum of IgM antibody when the antibody is in the serum. But when the IgM antibody bind with antigen or any bacteria, okay, it changes its conformation into a staple conformation in which the IgM show a binding site for C1Q protein, then the C1Q protein can be activated. So this is an initiator protein. So this is the reason That's why IgM antibody do not activate C1q initiator protein in the serum. So the first is, there are some complement proteins like C1q, C2, C3, C4, C5 and C6, C7, C8, C9. These are the complement protein, and there, for the classical complement pathway, there should be antibody and antigen complex formation. The soluble IgM or IgG cannot activate the C1q or initiator protein. So the next point is, in this case, in case of classical complement pathway, the initiator complement protein is C1q, that is associated with 1R and 1S, two actually are enzyme. These two enzyme actually helps this initiator protein to function. Okay, and there are another information you have to remember before you start to know what is complement pathway. That, let's assume this C2 or C3 or C4 or C5, this all complement protein, when cleaved or digested by a chain reaction, they produce two fragments. Both all these complement protein will produce two fragment. One is called C2A fragment, B fragment. So C2 will produce 2A, 2B, 3 will produce 3A, 3B, 4 will produce 4A, 4B and 5A, 5B. So after some chain reaction, this protein will be divided into two fragments. And in this case, I want to mention, in complement pathway, always, not always, but most of the time, the B chain or B fragment is the larger fragment. The B fragment is larger fragment and the A fragment is the smaller fragment. You have to remember this. But so you can see, this 3A is the smaller, 3B is the larger, 4A is the smaller, 4B is the larger, 5A is the smaller and 5B is the larger. These three molecule actually maintain the rule, but the exception is this. C2A is the larger fragment. So you have to remember this. C2A is the larger fragment and C2B is the smaller fragment. This is the only exception for the C2 protein. Only there is exception, but C3, C4, C5 maintain the B rule and A rule. B means larger and A means smaller. Okay. Before beginning, I have to mention this all. So I can write it like larger fragment are C2A, C3B, C4B and C5B are the larger fragment, and the smaller fragment are C2B, this is the exception, and C3A, C4A and C5A, these are the smaller fragment. You have to remember this before you begin to know the complement pathway. So first is proteins, then for the classical pathway, it have to a complex of antigen and antibody, then there is an initiator protein that initiate this reaction, and then the rest of the protein will get divided into two fragment. One is larger fragment, another is smaller fragment. There is only difference in the C 2A, 2B, because all the B fragments are larger and the A fragments are the smaller. And here is another information you have to remember this, that I have to mention all the smaller fragment like C3A, not this C2B, but C3A, C4A and C5A acts as a chemical that called anaphylatoxin. This chemical acts like an anaphylatoxin. What is anaphylatoxin? This chemical actually can induce immune cells. This chemical can induce immune cells, so that the immune cells secrete some cytokine, mainly pro-inflammatory cytokine. The example of pro-inflammatory cytokines you must remember is IL-1 beta, IL-6, IL-18 and TNF-alpha. These four chemicals are pro-inflammatory cytokines. When this anaphylatoxin, when this complement protein gets fragmented and the smaller fragment of the protein actually induce immune cells like neutrophil, dendritic cell, macrophage to produce cytokines like pro-inflammatory cytokines like IL-1 beta, IL-6, IL-18 and TNF-alpha, and anaphylatoxins actually induce inflammation. They induce inflammation. So the ultimate result is inflammation. So by complement pathway, the smaller fragments can induce inflammation. I want to mention this smaller fragment actually do not take part in the complement pathway directly. So this smaller part will not actually take involvement in the complement pathway. Only the larger fragment take part into the complement pathway. These fragments take part in the complement pathway. But I want to mention also in this case, the C3B protein not only act as a active member of complement pathway, but also acts as a opsonin. You have to remember this. This is one example of opsonin. Opsonin means when this molecule bind with any pathogen, it becomes actually tasty. The Greek meaning of opsonization means to make tasty. When the bacteria are coated with this C3B protein, the bacteria is getting make more tasty, so that the macrophages, neutrophil, dendritic, phagocytes can engulf or phagocytose those bacteria very efficiently. In one study, it was found that when any bacteria or pathogen are coated with opsonins, the efficiency of phagocytosis increases 4,000 times. So C3B also acts as opsonin. So by the complement pathway, inflammation can occur, opsonization can occur, and by the complement pathway, one important molecule is produced called MAC, that means membrane attack complex. This complex form a pore-like structure in the bacterial wall so that the bacteria actually die. So the classical complement pathway starts from binding of antigen and antibody. So let's assume this is a bacteria and this bacteria contains some antigen epitope, and this epitope is recognized by antibody. So this will become, now this will become the antigen antibody complex. Now this become antibody antigen complex, and when there is any antigen antibody complex, one protein called C1q protein can bind with this antigen antibody binding complex. C1q protein can bind. in the serum, C1q protein cannot bind with antibody. As I have already mentioned that in the serum, the IgM or IgG molecules present in a planar conformation. But when this antibody binds with antigen, it becomes staple in conformation, staple. And in this situation, there is, in this Fc region of the antibody, there is a region that can bind with the C1q protein. After binding the C1q, the C1q protein activate its partner. There are two partners in C1q protein, I have mentioned. One R and one S. These two are actually enzyme. So the C1q protein contain two 1R and two 1S molecule that are enzyme. After getting attached with the antigen antibody complex, C1q protein activate C1R partner. Then the C1R activate its own partner C1R, as because the C1R present in double, so C1R activated C1R, and then this C1R activates C1Q, C1S. It's another partner. So you can remember, it's very easy, because in alphabet we know QRS. So at first C1Q are activated, then QR, then S. QRS. This is very simple. You can remember it as a. So at first C1Q protein gets activated, it activates C1R, then C1S. So QRS, as we know alphabetically, it is comes in serial, QRST. So QRS, you can remember it as a. Now the C1S is actually a enzyme that can digest or cleave two product of this complement pathway. One is called C4 and another is called C2. You have to remember this. So as I have already mentioned, after getting fragmented, it produces two region. One is larger, that is called C4B, and then is smaller, C4A. And for C2, it will produce C2A and C2B. Very simple, you can remember. So first bacteria or any antigen with a antigen complex, then C1q protein bind. After binding, it activates its partner C1R. C1R activates its another partner C1R. Then C1R activates C1S. This C1S enzyme can cleave the C4 and C2 complement protein into two fragment. One is larger, one is smaller. And in this case, this is larger and this is smaller. You have to remember this. This is the exception. A. In complement pathway, always the B fragment are the larger. So 4B is larger fragment. Now this 4B, C4B attach with the C2A. These two larger fragments gets attached with each other. Now they become a one molecule, C4B and C2A. This is called C3 convertase. After attaching with the C4B and C2A, it becomes an enzyme that's called C3 convertase enzyme. Okay? The name implies that this complex C4B and C2A can cleave the C3 protein. So now it can cleave C3 protein because it is C3 convertase. It can convert the C3. So after cleaving the C3 also produces two fragments, C3B and C3A. The B is the larger fragment and A is the smaller fragment, as it is the rule. So after becoming the C3 convertase, the C4B C2A cleave the C3 product into C3B and C3A, and then the larger fragment, like this is the larger fragment, also attach with this larger fragment. They select this larger fragment. Okay, and this can be act as a anaphylatoxin. This 3A will perform its own function as a anaphylatoxin, and 3B can directly involve in the complement pathway or in the opsonization, because I have mentioned that this can also act as a opsonin. So it can actually function as a opsonization. So after cleaved, this fragment like C4B and C2A attach with the C3B protein and it become now a molecule, complex molecule. This is called C5 convertase enzyme. So now this complex C4B, C2A and C3B form C5 convertase enzyme that can cleave, the name implies that can cleave C5 component of the complement pathway, and also this fragment will produce two fragments, C5A and C5B. The A fragment is smaller and the B fragment is larger fragment. Let's assume this is a bacteria. So C5B attach, then C6, then C7, C8 and then C9 complex attach, and this C9 complement protein form multimeric. It means C9 binds with C9, starts to bind and form a structure like this, pore like structure, and each and every segment is composed of C9. This is called MAC, membrane attack complex, and this membrane attack complex can lyse the cell membrane of the bacteria, and the bacteria eventually die. After formation of the C5 convertase enzyme, the all three complement pathway like classical complement pathway, alternative complement pathway or lectin pathway converge into single pathway, that is the C5 protein is cleaved into two parts, C5A and 5B. The 5A is a smaller part and the 5B is larger part. So 5B and actually C5B associate with C6, then it recruit into the membrane, plasma membrane. After binding with C6, it recruit into the plasma membrane. Then C7 molecule can bind with the C6 and C5B complex. After binding, C8 also come and the C9 protein also bind with this complex, and multiple C9 protein actually form the pole like structure called MAC, membrane attack complex. So this is actually electron micrograph diagram. These are all MAC. As I have mentioned that the smaller parts or smaller components of or fragments of the complement protein like C3A, C5A, C4A acts as a anaphylatoxin, means induce inflammation. So this can also react on endothelial cells of blood vessels, like small complement cleavage products act on blood vessels to increase vascular permeability. So the permeability of these blood vessels increase and cell adhesion molecule. So increased permeability allows increased fluid leakage. So blood serum can now enter into the tissue, and blood serum contain different antibody and complement proteins. So increased leakage from the blood vessels and extravasation means transmigration of immune cells, also immunoglobulin and complement molecules, and migration of macrophage from the blood, polymorphonuclear leukocytes like neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil and lymphocytes is increased. So the microbicidal activity of macrophage PMN is also increased. So these smaller molecules also have larger role. In another diagram you can see the complement protein fragments in opsonization. As I have mentioned, complement pathway, opsonization and phagocytosis are very related. So you can see a bacteria is coated with C3B protein. Why? Because C3B can act as a opsonin. By binding near with the receptor like CR1,
that can bind with the C3 in the macrophage do not induce phagocytosis. You can see C5A receptor are present. So when C5A molecules bind with this receptor, it activates macrophage to phagocytose. So now you can see C3B protein, C5A can phagocytose, help to phagocytose. Here is another situation when antigen and immunoglobulin complex form in the blood, complement pathway activated, and C3B protein can bind with the antibody Fc region. This complex then recognized by erythrocyte or RBC that express very few CR1 receptor, and this erythrocyte actually come into liver or spleen, and in the liver or spleen there are macrophage dendritic cells that express huge number of this CR1. So it actually remove the complex and it gives to the phagocyte so that it can now phagocytose and cleave or digest this antigen.
So this is all about classical complement pathway, and in my next class I will explain lectin complement pathway and alternative complement pathway. Hope this video will help you. If you like this video, please share and subscribe my channel, and also you can write me in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and always keep learning.